Hello, this is Thomas from Hotkey404, and in this video I'll show you how to install OpenMediaVault 5 on Raspberry Pi 4 using just one command. If you thought that I would just show you this one command and we're done after 15 seconds, it's not quite right, because first we need to prepare our SD card. So we will use SD formatter. And as you can see, sometimes if there's some existing setup, we need to format it twice so that it shows success. And then we will use Raspberry Pi Imager, and I use 1.5 version, and select your card and Raspberry Pi OS. And inside in submenu, I will use light version because we don't need to spend resources on desktop. So once we have that, we will just hit write and wait for the system to download and write on the card. To save you some time, we will go times 50 with our speed, and after a second we will have our SD card with OS prepared. So it's time to remove the card from the computer, insert into Raspberry, connect Ethernet, connect keyboard, connect power source, and we can go with our installation. So it's time to install our software and to capture what is happening on the screen. You can use your display or some HDMI grabber. And as you can see, our OS is nice enough to readjust file system during first boot. And then after reboot and after a second, we will be able to log in to our Raspberry. And this is a clean system, so we will use Pi as our username and Raspberry as our password. Once we are logged in, we will use this tool that we know from our previous videos, which is sudo raspi-config, and it lets you change your password, change your time zone, change your keyboard layout, and all kinds of useful things. So please just explore this tool and adjust your system to your needs. And now it's finally time for our one command that we're going to use to install OpenMediaVault. So we will type sudo wget and after hyphen capital O and then space hyphen space and the address https://github.com/openmediavault/plugin/developers and then install script row master install and after pipe sudo bash, and that will start the process of installing our plugin, and it will take 45 minutes. So I will save you all that time and we will just skip to the end, and you will know that this is the end because the plugin installer will just reboot your system after it finishes. Of course, if you find it difficult to copy the command from the video, I encourage you to visit our website. You will find the tutorial on our hotkey404.com. So as we can see, we have rebooted our system. So we will once again log in with user pi, password raspberry, and I will type IPA to check the IP address of our system. And then we'll be able to switch to web browser and continue our setup. Once we have that, we will just use admin as username, OpenMediaVault as password, and I really love this software because you can install it basically on any hardware and there are so many options to use here. But I will just skip all that and we will go directly to storage and disks and try to connect some of those drives I have before me. So I will start with a regular USB thumb drive, hit scan, and we can see this on our system. I will connect something bigger. So once again, USB by 2.5 drive. And once again, we can see that. And then this contraption with some adapters, and this is a regular HDD pulled out from my PC. And once again, we can see that. So as you can see, you can connect basically anything to your Raspberry. So then probably you want to wipe out the drive and set up some file systems. So there's still a lot of work. As you can see, the installation is pretty straightforward. You just need to prepare SD card and use one command to install the software. But the work doesn't end here. Now you have to secure your system, choose which of those drives they want to use, create some file sharing services, install plugins, and so on. So there's still plenty of work to do. So good luck in your setup, and see you in the next one.